He has shown you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God. Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances. For this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Above all, love each other deeply, because love covers over a multitude of sins. Be confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Fight the good fight of the faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Keep your eyes on Jesus, who both began and finished this race we're in. Study how he did it. You are the body of Christ. Each one of you is a part of it. 1 Corinthians. The Lord has done it this very day. Let us rejoice today and be glad. When times are good, be happy, but when times are bad, consider this. God has made the one as well as the other. I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart. I have overcome the world. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. And the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast.